Jenna.
This campaign, because this is a cause that I really genuinely feel for. I think most of you might already be aware that I have an indie dog at home. Her name is Victoria, but we lovingly call her Vicky. What you probably are not so aware of is that while Vicky lives inside with us, we also have two other indies. They kind of in and out between being inside and outside the house, but they live in our compound and we look after them. So we have three of these dogs and we have 10 rescue cats. So that's one big, huge khandan of cats and dogs. But I would say that it's probably the best part of my day and life, and just to be surrounded by these animals who are an absolute delight. Coming back home to their smiling faces and their wagging tails is the best feeling of all. So for me, this is just, to be a part of this campaign is really, really special, because I genuinely believe in adopting and not shopping. There's so many cats and dogs on the street and in local shelters that need loving homes. So I'd like to take this opportunity to say that if there's anybody out there that has the time, the space, the patience, the resources, and most importantly, a lot of love to give and share, I would suggest you consider adopting from your local shelter or from the streets, because you can give an animal a chance at a new life and kind of change their destiny in a way. So, and also I'd like to say there's a lot of misconceptions about indie dogs, you know, the dogs on the street, cats. People are afraid of them for some reason. You know, they think they're a little temperamental, but I'd say from experience that that's not really true. They're just like other dogs. They just need to be socialized maybe a little bit. And if there's a dog that's with you from the time they're very, very young, they will grow into a family environment and understand humans more. And they're actually very, very loving. I'd say they're extremely intelligent, more intelligent than some thoroughbred dogs. And they're very hardy and very resilient. So while a lot of my friends have thoroughbred dogs that are visiting the vet every few weeks or months, I feel like indies just don't need, they're so low maintenance. They don't need a lot to survive. And that's also a great plus point, you know, with our busy lives and schedules and stuff. They're kind of just so hardy, they're okay on their own. So it's, you know, it's really a great addition to the family. And that's one misconception that I think they're very, very loving, they're extremely intelligent, and they will make your life wholesome.
That was about Vicky. So if you could share a few experiences, you know, how it has been like, you know, after adopting Vicky.
Like I said, she's my happy space. So whenever I'm low, feeling not so great, or, you know, I've had a really long, tiring day, and I sometimes just can't wait to get back home just to give her a big tight hug. Also, although she hates hugs, but it's torture for her. She hates being hugged, and she'll she'll act like she's being punished and it's the worst part of her day, but I will still go and do it. And it's such a good feeling. She has other ways of expressing her love, but mine is by hugging her. So whether she likes it or not, she has to put up with me. But yeah, she's honestly just, she has so much, she's so special and so highly intelligent. It's like a human being. Like, I talk to her like she's my sibling, and I think she thinks
and
that I'm
her
sibling.
They do understand.
So she bullies me, and she's got a personality of her own. And she's, you know, she makes it very clear what she's feeling or thinking. Can we allow her that space? You know, she's not one of those like sit, stand, roll over, like train. She's very trained. She listens to everything, but we don't want her to feel that, you know, we want her to be her own self and person, and, you know, have her personality shine through. So we allow her to express herself and respect her boundaries. So if she's not having a good day and she doesn't want to be touched or, you know, handled or whatever, and she kind of lets us know that we leave her alone.
And of course, they do have their own personalities. Yeah. You have to let them be.
Yeah. So
that's sweet. That's sweet. And just one last question, Dinah. Now it's summer and, you know, it's so hot. So there are so many animals on the street, and we get a lot of cases about you know, animals falling on streets or getting dehydrated. If you could tell us, like, what one can do to help animals. during summer time?
It's tough to have every single animal because there's so many of them on the street. But if you have a few animals in your local, your local animal that you look out for, feed them or whatever. It would be nice to leave bowls of water out for them, and if possible, allow them to, at least in the hot summer months, allow them to kind of seek shelter in maybe the common, shaded area, as opposed to being...
Or just let them inside your building.
Yeah, the entry of the building. Yeah. I'm not saying let them into your house, obviously, but... Yeah,
the compound, building about.
Just some kind of temporary shelter for them, at least in the day, when the sun is beating hard. So I think maybe just a few things like that. A bowl of water.
Everyone could keep like a bowl of water outside.
Of course. And if you feel, we actually currently have a cat that's outside of our gate. Mm-hmm. Little kitten actually. Mm-hmm. And noticed that a week ago that she was behaving very odd and looked like she was dehydrated and kind of very dull and lethargic. Mm-hmm. So we sent her to the vet. And yeah, she was very dehydrated because I had a bit of a heat stroke and I think some viral or something. So we're kind of just taking care of her temporarily outside until she's fit enough to be released back outside of the street. So whatever you can do, maybe send them to the vet or call a local shelter, call an organization like PETA, who can help if you can't do it yourself. Which is understandable, not everyone can do it themselves.
Yeah.
But I'm sure if they observe something like that, they can at least seek help elsewhere.
That's a lovely message and great tips. Thank you so much.